Hello and welcome to Samarth by Hyundai in partnership with NDTV. Over the last several months, we've spoken about issues around accessibility and inclusion for people with disabilities. Issues that have ranged from inclusive education and universal infrastructure design to mental health and the portrayal of disabilities in popular culture as well as assistive technology. Today we talk about the need and the importance of inclusive sport with a focus on para sports in India, and we wish India's athletes with disabilities all the very best as they represent India at important, critical international sporting events.
Hyundai ki pehel Samarth NDTV ke saath saajhedari mein Bharat ke liye padak jeetne ki chah mein hamare 6 divyang khiladiyon ka sahyog kar raha hai. Go Sports Foundation और समर्थनम ट्रस्ट के साथ अपनी साझेदारी के माध्यम से Hyundai ब्लाइंड क्रिकेट और 20 से भी ज़्यादा दूसरे दिव्यांग खिलाड़ियों को उनके खेल के सफर में मदद दे रहा है.
We'll be joined today by a wonderful panel. Deepa Malik, a Paralympian and former president of the Paralympic Committee of India. She's one of the most well-known faces, not just in India but around the world. She was the first Indian woman to win a medal at the Rio Games for India, for all of us. She's also the co-founder of Wheeling Happiness Foundation, which has been associated closely with the Samarth by Hyundai partnership with NDTV as critical partners as well in all of this.
Hamare saath hain Siddharth Upadhyay, president hain the Society for Transformation, Inclusion and Recognition Through Sports, TERS. Unhe saal 2016 mein Rashtriya Khel Protsahan Puraskar mila. उनकी स्टेस फॉर एबिलिटी पहल दिव्यांगों और उनके परिवारों को समावेशी शिक्षा, रोजगार, खेल और मनोरंजन तक समान पहुंच प्राप्त करने में सहायता करती है.
दीप्ति बोपाया, सीईओ गो स्पोर्ट्स फाउंडेशन. गो स्पोर्ट्स फाउंडेशन इज अ नेचुरल फिट फॉर समर्थ बाय Hyundai बिकॉज ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट सपोर्ट दैट दे प्रोवाइड एथलीट्स विद डिसेबिलिटीज. दैट्स पार्ट ऑफ दैट डीएनए. आई'd लाइक टू ऐड that they've also have the country's highest sports honor, the Rashtriya Khel Protsahan Award, for their role in supporting and creating sports champions. So thank you for being with us.
Aur hamare saath hain Aditya KV, founder aur CEO Umoya Sports. Umoya divyango aur gair divyang bachchon aur vyaktiyon ki sashakt unko banata hai, unhein jeevan kaushal sikhakar sharirik aur mansik roop se aatmanirbhar banata hai. स्कूलों में खेल और खेल आधारित शिक्षा कार्यक्रमों के माध्यम से समावेशी संस्कृति का निर्माण करके बेहतर जीवन जीने में सक्षम बनाता है.
डॉक्टर विजय दत्ता, प्रिंसिपल मॉडर्न स्कूल बाराखंबा रोड हियर इन दिल्ली. द स्कूल हैज एन इंक्लूसिव स्पोर्ट्स एकेडमी, स्पोर्टेबिलिटी फॉर चिल्ड्रन ऑफ ऑल एप्टीट्यूड्स एंड एबिलिटीज विद स्पोर्ट्स प्रोग्राम्स अडैप्टेड फॉर इंडिविजुअल्स विद फिजिकल डिसेबिलिटीज टू पार्टिसिपेट in terms of recreation, also to hone their skills in sports. They cover adapted sports for wheelchair users, amputees, visual and hearing impaired persons.
साथ ही हमारे साथ आज बहुत खास ऑडियंस भी है जिनमें उभरते हुए दिव्यांग खिलाड़ी, उनके प्रशिक्षक और माता पिता भी हमारे साथ आज स्टूडियो में हैं. तो दीपा, मेरा पहला सवाल आप ही से है. एक पैरालंपियन और भारतीय पैरालंपिक समिति की पूर्व अध्यक्ष के रूप में आपने रियो में अपनी जीत के बाद से हमारे देश में पैरा स्पोर्ट्स को किस तरह से आगे बढ़ते हुए देखा है?
मैंने 2016 के बाद बहुत बदलाव देखा है. जो स्ट्रगल्स हमारे रहे, इनिशियली स्पॉन्सरशिप नहीं थी, लैक ऑफ अवेयरनेस थी, पॉलिसीज वर नॉट इन प्लेस, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर वॉज नॉट देयर, देयर वॉज लैक ऑफ साइंस in sports, lack of nutrition knowledge, athletes didn't even know what is therapeutic use exemption certificate which protects them against any charges and allegations of eating a particular medicine which is a requirement for their health. Coaches, even media did not know how to report about the different disability categories. What were the rules and regulations, what were the assistive aids required. Aaj hamari policies samyukt hai, they are mainstream. Honorable Prime Minister himself takes accountability of every sport activity around disability sports. I do not say that the work is complete, there is a long way to go, but definitely we have done very well, and the results are showing in the form of the medals that continuously the para athletes are winning. Our 19 athletes in Rio got converted to 19 medals in Tokyo. Only one woman medal after so many years of independent India in Rio, which was mine. Now we are so proud to say that 3 female medals were won in Tokyo, and we are looking almost at 6 women medals there. So the graph is going up, and this year we are looking at a contingent which will be about 75 to 80 strong, thanks to initiatives like Samarth. This has hugely impacted awareness.
And it will hopefully continue to do that. Yes. But Siddharth Upadhyay, if I can ask you, tell us about STAIRS and its role in promoting inclusive sports in India.
This year, we'll be completing 25 years of STAIRS' existence. पिछले 25 सालों में मुझे लगता है कि स्पोर्ट्स को हम लोगों ने एक इंक्लूसिविटी के रूप में यूज़ किया है. वी लुक एट स्पोर्ट्स एज द बेस्ट टूल फॉर सोशल इंजीनियरिंग. सीढ़ियाँ चढ़िए, उतरिए, अपने हिसाब से करिए
जी.
यू आर एम्पावर योर सेल्फ. आर जॉब इज़ टू क्रिएट द इन्वायरमेंट, एंड वी हैव टू इंश्योर दैट यू गेट द राइट अपॉर्चुनिटीज वेर एवर यू आर. नाउ व्हेन वी लुक एट स्पोर्ट्स और व्हेन वी लुक एट डिसेबिलिटी, वी डोंट लुक एट इट एज अ सेपरेट सेगमेंट ऑल टुगेदर. 140 करोड़ लोग हैं इस देश में, और जो है वो है. उसमें मुझे लगता है कि सरकार का अपना अलग काम है, जो स्वयंसेवी संस्थान है हमारी जैसी, उनका अलग काम है, और आई थिंक हम सब यहाँ पे जितने लोग जुड़े हुए हैं वो सब अपने अपने तरीके से कंट्रीब्यूट कर रहे हैं. सो फॉर अस, यस, दे नीड सम स्पेशल केयर, सो यू नीड टू हैव स्पेशलिस्ट्स हु लुक एट देयर मेंटल वेलबींग, देयर फिजिकल वेलबींग, देयर सिक्योरिटी. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट वी ड्वेल्ड इनटू, एंड देन द होल आइडिया इज टू अंडरस्टैंड हु आर द पीपल हु आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल to create this kind of an infrastructure and create a dialogue with them.
Deepthi Popaiya, aapse sawal pooch lete hain. Zyada tar logo ko is baat ka ehsaas nahi hai ki Asian Para Games mein humne Asian Games se zyada padak jeete hain. Hamare divyang khiladiyon ke liye Bharat ki padak talika gair divyang khiladiyon ki padak talika se behtar rahi hai. Kai vijetaon ko apna sahyog dete hue Go Sports Foundation ne isme badi bhumika nibhai hai. क्या आप हमें बताना चाहेंगे कि दिव्यांग खिलाड़ियों का सहयोग करना हमेशा से गो स्पोर्ट्स फाउंडेशन के डीएनए में क्यों रहा है?
थैंक यू वेरी मच. फॉर अस एट गो स्पोर्ट्स वी स्टार्टेड सपोर्टिंग एबल बॉडीड एथलीट्स एंड एथलीट्स विद डिसेबिलिटीज फ्रॉम द स्टार्ट इटसेल्फ. आई थिंक फॉर अस स्पोर्ट वॉज द कॉमनैलिटी. जेंडर वॉज समथिंग दैट वी वॉन्टेड टू हैव बोथ जेंडर्स, एंड वी ऑल्सो वॉन्टेड टू इंश्योर दैट if we are talking about the pinnacle of sport as the Olympics, the parallel of the Olympics is the Paralympics exactly 3 weeks later. So I think in hamare mind pe there was no difference ki hame sirf able bodied or sport ke liye kuch karna hai, but from the start we're 16 going to be 16 very soon, and you know, for us it's always been about supporting talent. And thanks to people like Deepa Malik, Murlikant Petkar sir, and you know, all the other medalists who've come along the way, they are role models for India. They have shown that people with disabilities can actually go on and create an identity for themselves, even through sport. If India is in the top 5 countries in the world with people with disabilities, there is so much more to be done, and so much more, you know, ways in which everybody can come together and work with athletes with disability. And every single effort that Samarth and Hyundai are taking towards this is very, very exciting.
Yeah. Well, let me go across to Aditya. Tell us what inspired you to found Umoya Sports, and what exactly is your vision for sports in India?
Thank you. So we started Umoya in 2018 with a very lived experience, if I can say, and it was like a personal experience where I realized where people, like I was injured and I was bedridden for a very long time, and that gave me an understanding about the challenges, and there were very few limited opportunities for people in sports apart from the various other challenges, right, from accessibility to social stigma and everything. And then one of the major defining moment for us to start Umoya was when I was actually teaching in a government school, and I saw that there were children with special needs and various disabilities, and I saw how they were facing the same kind of challenges like which I kind of like faced, and then it affected them not just socially, emotionally, but also academically. The teachers did not have much expectations from them. And basically that led me to start an inclusive sports program during that time. And it just changed the entire narrative about those children. Teachers started coming, principal of the school started saying ki, sir, aap inko padhai mein to ye shayad peeche hain, magar aap inko sports mein aage karao. There was a different respect that the children started garnering. And I think that is essentially what everyone is looking for, that dignity.
Sure.
And that lack of opportunities essentially was the single point agenda for us to start Umoya. And now we started with, we work with special schools and children, with institutions working with children with disabilities, where we send in our team of adapted sports coaches to implement the program as part of the school curriculum.
Bilkul. तो आइए डॉक्टर दत्ता को पूछते हैं, प्रिंसिपल हैं बाराखंबा के, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद जुड़ने के लिए. डॉक्टर दत्ता, ऐसे समय में जब ज़्यादातर स्कूल एक समावेशी और सुलभ कैंपस और कार्यक्रम के बारे में नहीं सोच रहे थे, आपको इस क्षेत्र में आगे आने का विचार कैसे आया?
वेल, टू बी ऑनेस्ट, इट सो हैपेंड आई बीइंग ऑन द गवर्निंग बॉडी ऑफ द सीबीएसई केम बैक एंड वाज डिस्कसिंग विद आवर सेक्रेटरी बोर्ड ऑफ ट्रस्टीज Mrs. Ambika Pant about a special program, a special curriculum syllabus that should be there for the special needs children, children with special needs. And that's how she conceptualized the concept of sportability, which we are, I'm spearheading, we are as a school taking forward.
We're going to take a short break now, but as we do that, I just thought we'd tell all of you that we've got a wonderful third anchor on this program. And she's got a big smile on her face right now. Big smile, there you can see it. She's an Indian Sign Language expert. And we are so privileged to have you with us on this program. Thank you so much. A big clap for her. Welcome back to Samarth by Hyundai in partnership with NDTV Town Hall. Now, in this segment, let's talk about how we can capitalize on India's consistently improving performance in para sports to create a para sports ecosystem in our country that will percolate down to school levels and encourage more children with disabilities to participate in sport.
Bilkul. इस महत्वपूर्ण विषय पर चर्चा करते हुए हम एक इंक्लूसिव स्पोर्ट्स एनवायरनमेंट विकसित करने के पहलुओं पर बातचीत करेंगे, जिसमें इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर से लेकर फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट और स्किल डेवलपमेंट तक शामिल हैं।
Well, let me start by asking Dr. Dutta, the need for physical accessibilities in sports facilities. As a principal, sir, what challenges did you face in making sports inclusive for all students, and how are you addressing them?
Yeah, first of all, I would like to say that making them sensitive to this very concept took a little doing, because it was new to us, and as the children were not geared up with this concept to make them sensitive to the needs of the special needs children, and also to make all the other sports, all these sports in a friendly manner, mm-hmm. where they can be played by children in different fields, say basketball, football, tennis, wheelchair. Basketball happened in the school. Tennis, we saw how we can have it on the wheelchair. Badminton, every sport, we tried to make it happen with the children and increase our participation of all the students. And especially the swimming is one thing which is going and making waves, in the sense that a lot of kids are learning here. Earlier when they came, they hardly could get into water. But now that they are at a stage when they are competing at the national level, some of them who are visually impaired couldn't get into water. They were so scared. And today they are diving head first into water. So that is the kind of confidence we are able to generate among people with special needs. And of course, it goes without saying, there's been a Paralympics champion, Sharad Kumar, from the school. That was earlier. He was a boarder at the school. He went and brought a bronze to the country from the Tokyo Paralympics.
Yep. Deepthi, now let's explore the financial aspect in this, because cost can be a huge barrier to participation in inclusive sports. Is there a solution to this? Are sports scholarships, aids, partnerships, collaborations with NGOs, private enterprises, is all of this viable? And how easy, you know, is all of this to come by?
I'm not going to say it's easy. In the world of CSR, only 1% of it comes to sport. So it's very, very, very low. That has to increase. But having said that, the results that we see in Indian sport, corporate India has played a very, very important role. And today, when you talk about finances, you know, if you're playing a sport like badminton, you need to play almost 15 to 18 tournaments to keep your ranking in the top. So it's very difficult to play because we don't have many competitions within the country. So they have to travel abroad. So when you're talking about able-bodied athlete traveling for a competition, it's probably one person's cost. But a person with disability will have, you know, sometimes if they're on a wheelchair, they have people who need to be with them, to help them, to support them. They have their escorts working with them. They'll have a coach. So typically, if you end up spending, say, 2 lakhs for a tournament for an individual, if a para-athlete is traveling with their entourage, it automatically doubles or triples depending on the number of people that are going.
Siddharth, you work at the grassroots level for sports development. Is there a need to create inclusive playgrounds for children? That's something that, you know, is missing. How important are inclusive playgrounds?
That is the primary thing. Ye puri shuruaat hi wahin se hoti hai. So you have to have, you know, the approach that should be inclusive. And you also should have a playground that is inclusive. And you also have to take care of the security and other things. And that is something that government has to take care. So expecting private players to come and do all these things is little too much. But I'm sure it will happen in due course because, you know, here we are sitting here and, you know, creating and generating content. Once people start consuming this content the way they ought to, I'm sure the private players will get more encouraged and they'll start participating.
बिल्कुल so, जागरूकता फैलेगी इसी से
बिल्कुल
तब ये चर्चा हो रही है. दीपा, भारत में हमारे दिव्यांग खिलाड़ियों का जो समर्थन करने के लिए सुलभ बुनियादी ढांचे हों, अडैप्टिव स्पोर्ट्स इक्विपमेंट हो और कपड़ों के माध्यम से वर्तमान में सबसे अधिक जरूरी क्या आपको लगता है?
एंड टू एंड एक्सेसिबिलिटी इज डेफिनेटली द नीड ऑफ द आवर. और सोचने की बात यह है, आज अगर हम अवेयरनेस की बात करें, 1995 का जो बिल्डिंग कोड है या जो हमारी पॉलिसीज हैं, वो क्लियरली कहती हैं कि हर हिस्सा देश का सुगम्य हो. लेकिन कितनी बिल्डिंग्स ऐसी हैं जिन्होंने इस बिल्डिंग कोड को अपनाया है, या कौन सा इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ऐसा है जो इसको प्रायोरिटी पे रखता है? कई बार मैंने मेडल जीतने के बाद रियल इस्टेट रेगुलेटरी अथॉरिटी में भी कॉन्ट्रैक्चुअल पे जॉब किया था, मुझे दिया गया था. बिल्डर्स को बहुत इनक्रेज किया कि आप ऐसी इंक्लूसिव इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को क्यों नहीं बनाते हैं. इट इज़ टेकन एज एक्स्ट्रा कॉस्ट विच इज़ अ बेसिक नीड.
Like just continuing on what Deepa and Siddharth mentioned about, like, one is the physical infrastructure and the lack of access, but the other major challenge is the mindset, the lack of education, the lack of awareness. And this essentially is the pillar of what Umoya, what we are trying to work is, we call it a 3C philosophy. One is curriculum. In India, there are needs to have a curriculum which, like, not just a sporting curriculum, it needs to also educate at the grassroots level at the schools about disability, so the children come to know about disability, so that they build the skills of empathy and the values and like to create like that kind of a, like the, to break the social stigma, and to also have like the curriculum which is designed for children with disabilities as a sporting or the physical literacy curriculum. So curriculum is a very important aspect. Then the second is coach who understand the needs of children, who understand how to harness the abilities of the children, work on the strengths, and then build on their weaknesses, so that at the grassroots level they can go up to what, like how Deepti mentioned, how they can start going up the ladder to probably where Deepa reached. And yes, like, this is the kind of a role model, the inspirations that we need, but it needs to happen at the grassroots level, at the schools. And then the third is the culture. And this is where the social stigmas, having that kind of an inclusive culture is very essential. You need to kind of like bring people with and without disabilities to come out, play together. Until and unless children do not play and engage with children with disabilities, their abilities to understand, it's like a leadership program in itself for children without disabilities. And how your children of the school kind of like come, participate, play along with the children with disabilities.
Inclusive sports ecosystem banane ke liye bunyadi dhanche se lekar funding aur kushal coaching tak kai morcho par koshish karne ki zarurat hoti hai.
Indeed, and it is encouraging, Nidhi, to see the work being done by our panelists and their organizations. We're going to take a short break at this stage. Do stay tuned for more on our special show, Samarth by Hyundai, in partnership with NDTV.
एक बार फिर से आप सभी का स्वागत है। यह हंडे की पहल समर्थ है एनडीटीवी टाउन हॉल के साथ साझेदारी में। इस पहल के तहत हम भारत के 6 शहरों के स्कूल्स में संवेदनशीलता और जागरूकता कार्यशालाएं आयोजित कर रहे हैं।
We are also asking students to share their messages of support and best wishes for our para athletes through this activity. So let's go across to schools from across India where the Samarth by Hyundai inclusivity workshops are going on. Let's listen in to students' wishes.
We are Samarth Ambassadors.
I take the Samarth pledge for inclusivity. I am Samarth and I'll make others Samarth.
I take the Samarth pledge for inclusivity.
I am Samarth and I will make others Samarth too.
I pledge to promote inclusivity.
You made these cards with a lot of love and affection. We wish all the best.
All the best.
All the best.
The thing that I liked the most about this workshop was that they taught us about the fact that irrespective of their disability, they can do anything they want.
And today, yes, we will be talking about people with disabilities. We'll be talking about sports people who are.
Very warm and inspiring messages there from these kids for our athletes. Let's continue our conversation now around the importance of awareness and education about para sports in schools and the significance of youth engagement to bring about a change in societal perceptions.
बिल्कुल दीपा जी, एक सवाल आपसे यही है कि युवाओं को para sports के बारे में शिक्षित करना कितना महत्वपूर्ण है और इसका समाज पर क्या प्रभाव हो सकता है?
I think the best way to socially integrate and make any society inclusive is to introduce para sports, because para sports, when are heard and spoken of and schools go and attend these competitions, children have that impression of not charity, sympathy. They see them in action, they see them active, they see them winning medals, shooting an arrow with just feet or with no legs, using artificial limbs and running at a pace where even an able-bodied child will not be able to run, or making world records with artificial limbs. So I think it just makes them feel their outlook towards the disability changes. Yeah. A person in disability is always looked upon as a patient. Mm. But the moment you see them active in a field, you look at them as a person who's active, self-confident. So it works both ways. It not only empowers a person with disability, but also makes the outlook of a society inclusive in a very empowering manner.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Dr. Datta, you run an inclusive, you head an inclusive school. What I found interesting is that you've got tactile surfaces as
Absolutely.
Well for those who are visually disabled, braille markings
braille
as well.
Signages.
So that's important. Do you believe that something like this needs to be made mandatory for other schools as well?
Yes, of course.
How is it worked out? Is it effective?
It's very effective, right. Very effective. Because people who come in, they find the place disabled, friendly. So it's easy for them to come in. Reaching out is easier. They are very comfortable when they're there. The best part is when they give us compliments, they tell us that they're very comfortable being there is indeed gratifying.
There are railings all over, ramps everywhere, to the stage, anywhere. There's no place where somebody on a wheelchair can't reach. So making it very comfortable for them to be there, to enjoy their time there, feel very much part of the school, that is the idea. And we are making it happen. That is what is very special about it.
Vishnu, taking it from here, when children who are not with a disability, when they watch the ramps, tactiles, the braille, they will grow up to become custodians of the right processes, whether they're engineers, doctors, pilots.
Yeah, because they've normalized it.
They have normalized it. So when they are grown up working in an institute, organization, in the government positions, they will have a value system of inclusion, which we embedded as a child, and they will always remember. So the policies which are lying in the books will actually be executed on the ground.
बिल्कुल. सिद्धार्थ, क्या आप जो दिव्यांग खिलाड़ी हैं उनके सामने आने वाली जो चुनौतियां हैं उनको दर्शाने वाले कुछ आंकड़े उदाहरण दे सकते हैं, और क्या आप समावेशिकता से जुड़ी किसी हालिया प्रगति या नीति के बारे में भी बता सकते हैं?
देखिए, 14 से 15 करोड़ से भी ज़्यादा दिव्यांग अगर हम लोग रफ नंबर्स लें तो इस देश में हैं, और मुझे नहीं लगता कि 14 से 15 करोड़ दिव्यांगों को खिलाने की सुविधाएं देश में मौजूद हैं इस वक्त. एक बहुत बड़ा नंबर है जिसको हमको समझना पड़ेगा और इसको हमको ब्रेक करना पड़ेगा नीचे तक. तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि हमें प्रोग्राम्स बनाने चाहिए जहाँ पे हम लोग विलेज के लेवल पे, वार्ड के लेवल पे, सिटी के लेवल पे, शहर के लेवल पे, जिले के लेवल पे हीरोज़ क्रिएट करें. जैसे एक छोटा मैं आपको एग्जांपल देता हूँ. 2012 में मैं ट्रैवल कर रहा था कुशीनगर में, और वहाँ के जो डीएम थे, रिगजिन सैम्फिल, आई मस्ट टेक हिज नेम, आई वांट टू डू समथिंग फॉर डिसेबल्ड आउट. सो आई स्पोक टू हिम एंड आई सेड, ओके, आई हैव गॉट कैप्टन ऑफ इंडियन क्रिकेट टीम, वाइस कैप्टन, ऑल दिस पीपल, दे हैड बीन प्लेइंग विद अस विद वन ऑफ आवर प्रोग्राम्स. आई सेड, सी, आई वांट टू ब्रिंग देम हियर, एंड हाउ मेनी डिसेबल्ड वुड बी देयर इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट? ही सेड, अप्रॉक्सिमेटली 50,000. मैंने कहा, इफ आई डू समथिंग व्हाट विल यू डू? This is 2011 and 12.
Yeah.
He said, I'll help you out. मैं कहा, ठीक है जी. हमने कहा, एक क्रिकेट का प्रोग्राम करते हैं आपके यहाँ. Let us see how many kids come. सारी बात हो गई, हमने प्रचार प्रसार कर दिया. He calls me 3 days back.
Yeah.
He said, Siddharth, now you come. And now you'll understand the problems. He said, प्रोग्राम आपने बना दिया, स्टेडियम मैंने आपको दे दिया, DSO को मैंने काम पे लगा दिया. कह रहे, अब ये बताइए कि गाँव से ये बच्चे आएंगे कैसे?
Right.
The gentleman asked me. I said, आ जाएंगे. He said, नहीं, नहीं आ पाएंगे. Then he spoke to the RTO. He put 200 buses. And he put the staff. Yeah. And then all the kids from approximately 400 to 500 villages, they could reach Kushinagar Cricket Stadium. और बहुत बड़ा प्रोग्राम हुआ और बहुत समय तक वो स्टेडियम हमने चलाया. दिल्ली में भी हमने बहुत सारे काम किए इस तरीके के. तो ये सब मूलभूत परेशानियां हैं जो जगह के हिसाब से हैं. लोग वहाँ कैसे सोचते हैं, कैसे ऑपरेट करते हैं, वहाँ का एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर किस तरीके का आदमी है. 20 लाख स्कूल्स हैं देश में. आप सर्वे करा लीजिए 20 लाख स्कूलों का, आप देख लीजिए कि कितने स्कूलों में वो मुहैया है. हमारे साथ एक ऑनर्ड प्रिंसिपल बैठे हुए हैं और वो अपने.
बट इट्स सच एन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. एंड टू एंड ट्रांसपोर्ट सॉल्यूशंस आर इंपेरेटिव. वी कांट बी टॉकिंग अबाउट इंक्लूसिव स्पोर्ट इन आइसोलेशन. हाउ डज वन प्ले एन इंक्लूसिव स्पोर्ट? राइट,
आई मीन वन हैज टू रीच द प्लेस, राइट?
एग्जैक्टली,
रीच द वेन्यू.
इंटरडिपेंडेंट
इट इज. Let's, Aditya, dive deeper into the potential of emerging technologies in enhancing sports. What are some of the innovative solutions that you've been working on?
Like, technology is one of the biggest pillar to support anyone's journey, absolutely, right? Whether it is education or, and thankfully there are a lot of assistive devices, assistive technology, a lot of advancement in technologies. Like, as simple as, like, there is a platform which actually helps you to understand the classification by yourself. So there are such technologies, and then moreover, like that, like there are right now devices which kind of like help you to understand your own body dynamics. Your like the medicines have created like kinesiology. All those things are various important technologies. The sports sciences have increased a lot, and right now I do see like there are a lot of corporates like GSW and all, they have started their own sports sciences centers for people with disabilities. I think these are the things which are, I think, building on, which are coming up, which actually help children to identify what aspect of their physiological elements that need to be further worked on, that need additional support. So, yeah. So, technologies are, like, I think, at the end of the day, it is all about understanding how those technologies which are there at an elite level percolates to the bottom of the pyramid at the grassroots level.
Nidhi?
बिल्कुल दीप्ति, मेरा सवाल आपसे कि इस ये सब काफ़ी दिलचस्प है और क्या आप हमें खेलों में सुलभता को बढ़ाने में तकनीक की क्षमता के बारे में भी बता सकती हैं? हम जानते हैं कि तकनीक खेल में सुलभता को बहुत हद तक बेहतर बना सकती है, चाहे वो वर्चुअल रियलिटी के माध्यम से हो या प्रशिक्षण और सहायता प्रदान करने वाले ऐप्स के माध्यम से हो। आप इन इनोवेटिव समाधानों को अडैप्टिव स्पोर्ट्स में कुछ फिजिकल और लॉजिस्टिकल बाधाओं को दूर करने के लिए कैसे देखती हैं?
आई थिंक एक कॉम्बिनेशन है, अगेन डिपेंडिंग ऑन द एथलीट्स रिक्वायरमेंट एंड डिसेबिलिटी, वेदर इट्स प्रोस्थेटिक्स और ऑटोमेटिक व्हीलचेयर्स फॉर मूवमेंट, डिपेंडिंग ऑन हाउ इट हैज़ टू बी कस्टमाइज्ड, बहुत अलग अलग चीज़ हैं। But I think we have some time to get there. You know, Siddharth gave some staggering numbers. What is happening ki elite sport mein, at the top, there are these role models and there are these athletes doing very well. And then at the ground level, they want to get there, but the ladder is not built. And I think conversations like this, projects that are happening on ground have to be able to link the community, the grassroots to the elite. So technology plays an important role, sports science plays an important role, but it is important for elite sport that it is customized to the requirement of the athlete.
बिल्कुल, आपने पैरा स्पोर्ट्स के बारे में, आप सबने जो प्रगति कर रहे हैं हम उसके बारे में जानकारी दी है, लेकिन अधिक समावेशी खेल का माहौल बनाने में तकनीक और शिक्षा सबसे महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभाते हैं।
Absolutely, and you know, it is inspiring to see the dedication of our panelists in driving this change. It's fantastic talking to them. We're going to take another quick break. Do stay tuned for more on our special show, Samarth by Hyundai, in partnership with us, NDTV. Yeah.
इस बातचीत में आपका फिर से स्वागत है। हंडे की पहल समर्थ एनडीटीवी के साथ साझेदारी में, ये एक ऐसी पहल है जो भारत में दिव्यांगों के लिए अधिक जागरूक और समावेशी समाज बनाने की दिशा में एक महत्वपूर्ण कदम है।
एजुकेटिंग बोथ द स्कूल एंड द वाइडर कम्युनिटी ऑन द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ इंक्लूसिव स्पोर्ट्स कैन हेल्प ब्रेक डाउन सोशल एंड कल्चरल बैरियर्स इन्वॉल्विंग पेरेंट्स, स्टूडेंट्स एंड कम्युनिटी लीडर्स in awareness initiatives and activities, fosters inclusivity and support for such sports programs. We've got a wonderful group of students with us, and we'd like to thank all of you for being with us. You had a comment to make, and my question to you, in fact, is this. How important is it to normalize disability?
So I really think that this really normalizes the conversation. It makes it a dinner table conversation for everyone. So before joining Modern Barakhamba, I don't think I had ever really interacted with a person with disabilities. But then with going from never having interacted with someone like with such special needs to swimming with them, to walking in the same corridors as them, it really normalizes the situation. And the fact that all the panelists today mentioned that 15 to 16% of the entire world population has some sort of disability. So when there's such a large percentage of people with special needs, we really need to normalize that. And as students who witness people excelling with special needs in these sports, it really makes us see eye to eye with them. So,
क्या बदलाव आपने हाल में देखा है या कि क्या चीजें और हमें बदलने की जरूरत है?
मेरा नाम अभिषेक कुमार है, मैं व्हीलचेयर क्रिकेट खेलता हूँ, इंडिया के लेवल भी एक मैच खेल रखा है और दिल्ली टीम से भी खेलता हूँ। बारहखंबा में प्रैक्टिस करते हैं हर संडे को, हमारे सर बैठे यहाँ पे और मैं व्हीलचेयर जोमेटो का डिलीवरी भी करता हूँ डेढ़ साल से द्वारका में
जी।
तो मैं वहाँ देखा हूँ कि कई लोग मुझे विश्वास नहीं करते आप डिलीवरी का काम करते हो, क्योंकि वहाँ पर अधिकांश अपार्टमेंट है जो मैं ऊपर जाकर ऑर्डर देता हूँ, चाहे 10वीं मंजिल हो, चाहे 8वीं हो, चाहे कोई भी हो, जिसपे नहीं होता है तो मैं कस्टमर को बुलाना पड़ता है। तो सोचते भी आप कैसे आए हो, मैं व्हील चेयर लेके आया हूँ, तो आप व्हील चेयर डिलीवरी करते हो? तो बोले मैं उनको नीचे बुलाता हूँ, तो पूछते हैं फ़ोन पे, तो अब आते हैं तो देखते हैं हाँ जी बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हो, पर सपोर्ट करते हैं। देखा हूँ कि बहुत बड़ी बड़ी बिल्डिंग है, वहाँ पर लिफ्ट है, कई जगह क्या है कि वहाँ लिफ्ट है फिर भी हम नहीं जा सकते, कोई ऊपर रैंप बिना रैंप के ऊपर है या कोई नीचे हल्का सा है, उसमें भी दिक्कत आती है हमें।
ये बहुत
बेटा, आई एम टोल्ड यू आर अ रियल स्पोर्टिंग स्टार। What sports do you participate in?
Hello sir, my name is Ayush and I'm from class 10th and I play multiple sports like wheelchair basketball, wheelchair badminton and para swimming, and I am doing this for last 3 years, and before this I cannot do anything on my own, but now I can shift from one wheelchair to second. All of the credit I get to my coaches, my parents, because they just support me in every time, and the school itself gives me many new approaches towards the sports.
जीवन में कितना बदलाव आया है जो इस तरह का अगर बच्चों को अनुभव मिल रहा है, स्कूल में जा रहे हैं, मल्टी स्पोर्ट्स खेल रहे हैं, क्योंकि आप जो कहेंगे हमारे देश के तमाम स्कूल जो हैं, सिद्धार्थ बता रहे थे 20 लाख स्कूल्स हैं, उसमें भी कुछ ये शुरुआत हो सकती है। जी,
ऐसे बच्चों के लिए पहले तो मैं जब इसको लेकर चला था कहीं भी सपोर्ट नहीं मिलता था। जब मैं बाराखंबा पहुंचा, लोकेश सर से बात हुई, तब इन्होंने बताया हाँ जी ये बहुत कुछ कर सकता है। मेरे को तो 1% भी उम्मीद नहीं थी कभी ये स्विमिंग कर भी पाएगा। आज इतनी बड़ी स्विमिंग कर लेता है कि नेशनल में गोल्ड मेडल जीत गया है।
Let me ask a question to any one of you. Being friends with people with disabilities. People with disabilities may not be able to run. They may not be able to sort of physically move as fast. You might, depending on the disability, need to spend more time communicating with them. You're all very busy. But when you talk about normalizing friendships, you know, is this something that you factored in, that just comes normally to you?
दोस्ती एहसास है, जिसे आप टाइम के साथ या बैठ के नहीं जी सकते। जब आप नॉर्मलाइज की बात करते हैं, इंक्लूसिव की बात करते हैं, तो दोस्त के साथ हम ये नहीं देखते दोस्त मेरे साथ चल सकता है, दोस्त के साथ हम देखते हैं कि साथ है। और जब हम इंक्लूजन की बात करते हैं स्पोर्ट्स में, शायद पैरा स्पोर्ट्स में खासकर अगर मैं बात करूँ या स्पेशल स्पोर्ट्स में बात करूँ, तो हमें साथ की ज़रूरत है
जी।
चाहे वो व्हीलचेयर का हमारे साथ हो, वो भी हमारी एक दोस्त है एक तरीके से, चाहे ह्यूमंस का साथ हो, वो भी हमारे दोस्त हैं। तो दोस्ती एक एहसास है जिसके साथ हम आगे बढ़ सकते हैं।
समथिंग दैट आई वुड लाइक टू से इज दैट सोशल सिक्योरिटी इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड फ्रेंडशिप प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन दैट। I'm an athlete myself and I've been training with para-athletes at my academy, and it's so encouraging to see them overcome all the social stigmas, all the obstacles their way, and make a place for themselves. So I have interacted with them, spoken to them about their struggles and how long it took them to, you know, come out of that situation and the confidence building. And I have a friend who is a para-athlete, and we encourage each other. She encourages me, and I encourage her. So I think that's a very important thing.
What does she play, and what do you play?
I am a 100-meter sprinter, and she's a 200-meter and 100-meter sprinter as well.
That's super.
Wow, that. ये इसी तरह की दोस्ती की ज़रूरत है शायद। सिद्धार्थ, तो अब हम अंत में आ रहे हैं और आप सब पैनलिस्ट से जानना चाहेंगे। पहले आपसे शुरुआत करती हूँ कि अगले 5 साल में, आगे भविष्य में आप क्या देखना चाहते हैं इस पैरा स्पोर्ट्स के क्षेत्र में?
मुझे लगता है कि इन बच्चों ने जो बात बोली और जो फैक्ट एस्टैब्लिश किया कि चीज़ें नॉर्मलाइज होनी चाहिए, एक प्लेटफॉर्म पे सभी खेलने चाहिए और सभी एक दूसरे के साथ इंटरेक्ट करने चाहिए।
वन की स्टेप दैट यू'ड लाइक टू सी इन अ फाइनाइट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम,
लाइक आई थिंक माय वन थिंग वुड बी प्रोबेबली in the sense of education and awareness, in building more aware like initiatives, like so which brings more voice, which makes idols within relatable idols for children with disabilities, and bringing like a lot more grassroots level initiatives which will essentially help create that ladder for a young child to create, like ताकि उनको पता चल सके कि आगे अगर उनको एथलीट बनना है तो उनका रास्ता क्या है।
मैं अपने विकसित भारत को संयुक्त भारत देखना चाहती हूँ, जहाँ पे ओलंपिक की तैयारी हो रही है तो पैरालंपिक की तैयारी बराबर हो। और मैं अपने मेडल की गिनती ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बढ़ते देखना चाहती हूँ। वो तभी होगा जब हम ज़्यादा खेलों में भाग लेंगे। सो टू इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ स्पोर्ट, वी हैव टू इंक्रीज दैट नंबर ऑफ फैसिलिटीज, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, सो दैट मोर एंड मोर पर्सन्स विद डिसेबिलिटी कैन कम आउट एंड प्ले एंड राइट फ्रॉम द ग्रास रूट लेवल टिल द एलीट लेवल।
डॉक्टर दत्ता?
Well, I think CSR should come forward more promptly in a bigger way, to help because it's the mayor that money that makes the mayor go.
Yep.
So the financial supports should come in to have these systems take the next level, go several notches up, and we are able to raise the bar, as we say.
I think the panelists already have summarized it, but what I would like to really see is ki zyada classifications events ho India mein, and more grassroots and community athletes can participate and get their classification and inevitably, you know, create an identity.
तो हमारे सभी मेहमानों और दर्शकों को इस महत्वपूर्ण बातचीत का हिस्सा बनने के लिए धन्यवाद। नामुमकिन कुछ भी नहीं है। अगर हम सब एक दूसरे के साथ हैं तो एक साथ मिलकर हम सभी के लिए एक अधिक समावेशी और सुलभ दुनिया बना सकते हैं।
Thank you for watching and remember in sports and indeed in life it is our abilities that truly matter. We leave you with this very special Samarth by Hyundai anthem. It encourages, supports and wishes our athletes the best of luck in their quest for winning medals for India.
Tu soch le ab to udna hai tu soch pahad se bhidna hai tu soch le ab to udna hai tu soch pahad se bhidna hai tu soch ke ambar na penge tu soch ke gir ke udna hai जैसा जैसा सोचेगा हम वैसा मंजर कर दे